I'm going to show you how to replace the master cylinder, the brake lines, and finish up the Cadillac CTS-V brake swap on my Nissan 240SX S13. Welcome back to RevMatch. This is the second video of two. In the first one, I showed you guys how to install the calipers and the rotors on my Nissan 240SX. If you guys are new here, I do how-to videos, track videos, and car reviews, so hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell so you'll be notified when I make another video. I have split up this video into parts to make it easy for you. You can go down into the comments and click on the part that you want to see and you'll jump right to it, or you can just scroll to the part that you want to see using the scrubber. Here are the parts that you're going to need for the swap. A 1995 Nissan 300ZX twin-turbo master cylinder. Stainless steel brake lines. We're going to start with removing the master cylinder, and what I've done is I have marked the lines with blue tape, 1, 2, 3, so I know how they're going to go back into the car. So to get the master cylinder off the booster, it's a 12 millimeter. The master cylinder that I bought from O'Reilly does not come with a reservoir, so I'm going to take this reservoir off and reuse it. There's a fitting that we need to move from the old master cylinder to the new one, so we're gonna cut it out very carefully. I'm gonna use this to start. It's gonna be a little bit too aggressive, and then I'm gonna switch to a finer Dremel tool to take the thing out at the end. We've got a fitting in the new master cylinder that needs to come out, and then after that, we're gonna put this little piece that we took out of the old master cylinder, we're gonna tap that in. All right, I'm just gonna tap this fitting in. I want to give another really big shout out to Counterspace Garage for helping me out with this video. You guys are amazing. Now I'm going to move the reservoir over to the new master cylinder. There's a plug on it, and this plug needs to go pointing out towards the fender on the driver's side, so it's going to go in like this. So to get it in, I flipped it upside down on the counter with the reservoir upside down, and then I basically pushed down as hard as I could with all my weight to get it down in. While you guys were gone, I put a quick shot of paint on the brake booster. I'm putting a little bit of high temperature grease on this arm just to lube things up nicely. Now I'm going to install the new master cylinder. Next, the brake lines go back onto the master cylinder. So I want to get the old brake lines off. It's a 10 millimeter wrench. So I'm going to take this bracket off as well because it's going to make it a lot easier to deal with installing the new brake lines. The bracket is attached to the brake line with this clip, so I'm going to remove this clip and then put the new brake line on. The clip is attached, the new brake line is attached. When you're attaching the brake line to the bracket, don't worry too much about which way it goes. This thing does rotate nicely, so when you're putting the brake line in, just make sure that this banjo end is facing downwards. So the next part is we want to take this line and move it to the bottom and take these bleeders and move them to the top. Now you might think that a 10 doesn't fit properly, but actually it does. It's just that there is paint on these lines. They were painted obviously after the lines went in. Now I'm going to install the brake line, and you want to make sure that you've got a washer on the caliper and a washer on the bolt. I want to make sure that the line is pointing a little bit back towards the inside of the car, and I'm just going to tighten it up a little bit loosely right now. And finally, we put the pads in. I love how simple it is on this car. The pads just slide right in like that. You put a clip in, and then you put two pins in, and you hammer them in, and that's pretty much it. If you guys are not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button and that little bell, and you'll be notified when I make another video. And I'll see you guys in a couple days.